classmates. It's a 10-inch atom-based ruggedized product, which features a tablet swivel screen. Some of the niche features on this product is a swivel camera, which can then be controlled from the button board located on the screen. If you've got an e-book on there, you can also control it as an e-reader with these key functions here. Obviously, the project is an Intel-based design. It's been aimed at children, so it's drop tested to 70 centimeters. The screen and keyboard are both spill-proof. Part of our branding and exercising of the product, we're offering it with a 3-year warranty. With this product, again, it's also has two audio ports on it there, so if you're with a child, you can then the teacher can listen in on what the kid's doing as well. They have a stylus which is located on the side of the machine. USB memory card slots. Some of the niche features that we'll be doing on this product is featuring 3G SIM card updates. We'll also configure it to whatever your spec requirement is. So up to 2GB, XP Pro, and Win 7 starter. So that's a lot of the key features on this.
And at this feature level, so with the 500GB hard drive, the Atom and the 2GB, what's the price point on the product here?
The entry level price point on this for the BETT show has been $319. That's with a 3-year warranty included also. Obviously, depending on how you spec it, it will then drive the price point. $319 is with a 1GB, 160GB hard drive and the Atom processor, which is service mounted on the board.
Okay, I'm logging into the device using a 4-digit passcode, so it identifies me as a member of staff. There's a local database which is encrypted to the machine. If I backed up the data from this iPad and restored it to a second iPad, I would not be able to read the data. So the data is secure. If I'm in a Wi-Fi zone, I'll be working and immediately synchronizing to the SIM's data. If I'm working away from a Wi-Fi zone, I'll be working to a local database. If I walk back into range of Wi-Fi, it will automatically synchronize. No buttons to press. A member staff walk around the school can click on the students button and find any student in the school by name, year and reg, subject, timetable, house. I'll put year and reg. It gives me a list of the year groups and the number of students in each year group, the number of reg groups in each year group at a glance. Click on year 10. It gives me a list of the reg groups. I choose a reg group and I get a list of the students and the photographs, so I can identify the students I'm looking at very easily. If I select a student, I then get a summary of their attendance. I can look at the timetable so I know where they should be now. If there's an emergency, I can pick up the emergency contact details immediately and know where to phone. It doesn't hit a lot of areas of SIMS, but what it does well. It's easy to use, and if I want to take a register, click on my registers, it knows who I am, I'm associated with the machine, my PIN's been entered. If I pick today, it knows that there's no lesson on currently, but it's got all today's lessons showing, plus AM and PM registration. If I pick a Friday afternoon lesson, then I can take my register by just touching the student record. I can change it from present to absent by double-clicking. I can pick up a list of codes in case it's a code I don't use very regularly. I can pick the relevant code, enter the register and save. It will save to the local database if I'm offline. It will immediately synchronize to the SIMS database if I'm online. And if I'm working on the playing field as a BEAM member staff, as soon as I walk back into the school, I will synchronize. I don't have to remember to press a button. On a school trip, I could take all the student information with me. I can take the register during the day, and again, it's all synchronized back at base. If there's an accident during the trip, I've got all the emergency data at my fingertips. I'm not going to save the changes. what we're seeing at the moment is on an iPad. If this was an iPhone, the screen would be just the same, but obviously less real estate, a smaller display. The same Apple application is running to do this work. Brookhorn have been working with Sims for many years, and the interface they use for their current text messaging and email system, the same interface is used for this product, which is why I've been able to develop it so quickly. They're enhancing the product and bringing in assessment and behavior. I don't know the time scales on those, but they are working plain. That's basically it. I can look at members of staff as well. So I can look at whatever details I as an individual am allowed to see. If I need the emergency contacts for staff, I can get them.